Usually, my morning starts at 5:30 a.m. and my husband leaves at 7. So my morning is quite hectic. I have to cook breakfast and lunch, so I don't really have time to shoot. But my breakfast is usually the same as this one, which was a day when it's holiday. So for the day, I had some leftover chow mein from the dinner last night and had some rice paper. So I made some rice paper spring rolls. And oh my god, they were so good. You just need to soak the rice paper in water for a second and then you're good to go. And the chai is the constant thing. I love chai. I have it 2 times a day, every day. So here is me making the chai for both of us. My husband is a good baker and he makes the great breads. We have like a small tin that explains the size of the bread, and I really love chili cheese toast. I still can't forget the taste of it. I had it when I had it for the first time in Mukherjee Nagar, which got closed later, and I can't get over that taste. That was the best chili cheese toast I ever had. So I am using a homemade chipotle. Out of all the spreads, I love chipotle the most. The one we get in the market have lots of palm oil, so I try to make it at home and it is actually tasty, very tasty than the market one. I like the taste of it now, so I use it almost every time I make breads or sandwiches or whatever. So yeah, that's the chipotle I have used, and then some bell peppers and seasonings, and that's it. That was just put it in an oven for a few minutes and your breakfast is ready with chai, of course. When I get bored of my usual breakfast, and you know, we are like binging on sev puri madly these days, so I made them quickly. You'll always find green chutneys and tamarind chutneys in my fridge, like always. I can't not have them. So this is the chutneys and this is the sev puri basically that I am making for my breakfast on day 3rd. It's very hot right now, so it's a good breakfast option. I mean, I don't know if it's a breakfast option, but we both were craving for sev puri that day, so we had it. Just to let you know, this is not how I used to make pohas earlier. I mean, I would add a hell lot of vegetables in that, and my husband hates that. He made me stop putting veggies in poha and asked me to make it a simple and authentic. And you know, I kind of love it in this way now. Earlier, I would hate the peanuts in my poha. I would hate them. Like now, right now, I eat peanuts in my poha more than he does. So yeah, that's a change. And yeah, it tastes good. I mean, I still prefer taking them out and then add the masala and everything and then eat the peanuts as toppings. But yeah, I am now used to them. This, my friend, is the best macaroni recipe ever, like you will ever find. Of course, it's an Indian style and we agreed to put a lot of veggies in it. It tastes so good. Just a simple tip, don't forget your garlic in this. Trust me on this. I might share a detailed recipe if you guys will want. Just let me know. And I am telling you, this is the best macaroni recipe ever. Like, I have made a lot of macaronis and I have tested and tried this method. Oh my god, this is the best. The whole winter, I either had methi ka tepla or this hara bara kabab. This is so full of protein and such tasty breakfast option, and it just melts in your mouth the moment you have it. This is my absolute favorite. Tell me yours favorite in my comment section. Which one did you prefer? So yeah, that's all for this video. I hope you like it. Do give it a thumbs up and comment.